Union is so much inferior to this likeness of Emperor Nero, which was minted 300 years earlier. All of life was marked by the prevailing apathy. And as the Roman economy slumped lower and lower, burdened by a costly government and by inflation, authoritarianism increased in order to try to set off the apathy. And as less people were inclined to work, the state took over more and more, and more freedoms were lost. For example, laws were passed binding the small farmer to his land. And because of the apathy and its results and the oppression, few people thought the old civilization was worth saving. Rome did not collapse because of outward forces such as the barbarians, but because of inward rottenness. And Rome gradually became a ruin. The conclusion I draw looking at the Roman era is the fact that nothing humanistic provides a strong enough base for society, as well as the individual life of the individual man and woman. The Greeks and the Romans tried magnificently to first build on society, on those people who made up their society, which is an exclusive elitist society. But those people, they tried to build on this and totally failed. And then they tried to build on finite gods, gods that were not the infinite personal God. And this equally failed. It brings a simple conclusion. There is no foundation strong enough for society within the realm of finiteness, and beginning for man alone and as autonomous. The other side, of course, is that the Christians were able to stand. But the reason they were able to resist the syncretism of that day and the breakdown and face the arena, really face it with certainty, is because they began at exactly the opposite place. They began with the existence of an infinite personal God, and that he had spoken, and they had the truth in the Old and the Testament, in the revelation of Christ, and in the growing, the then growing, New Testament.